Ave Maria, hope you're doing well. Today we are going to discuss my favorite sacramental, the brown scapular of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Now, if you're a Catholic and you've never heard of the scapular, please be attentive. And please make sure you get the brown scapular and put it on. Now, this is what a scapular looks like. Is it? This is what the scapula looks like this. So, the scapula, basically, there are two pieces of wool held by anything, whether a string or a cord, doesn't matter. What matters are these two pieces of wool. So, before we start, I'll first give the historical or biblical background of the brown scapula of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Now, in the Old Testament, in the book of Genesis, there is a story about Jacob and his brother Esau, and how Jacob got the blessing of his brother. If you pay attention to that story, you'll find that it prefigures the scapula, because Jacob was devoted to his mother. He was a calm boy, he was quiet. His brother Esau was outgoing and the favorite of his father, and his father wanted to give him the blessings of the heir. So when time came, somehow the mother of Jacob convinced Jacob to be the one to take that blessing instead of Esau. But Esau was hairy. So, since Isaac was the father of Esau and Jacob, they were twins. Since Isaac's eyes had gone dim, he was becoming blind, the mother put some hair from a goat on Jacob because Esau was a hairy boy. So, when the father wanted to confirm that it was Esau, he touched him and felt the hairs of the goat and thought it was Esau. And that's what the scapula does. When we go before God the Father clothed in the scapula, God sees his son Jesus. It is his righteousness that we use to qualify to go to heaven. That is what the grace of God is all about. It is the grace of Jesus that takes us to heaven. That's what the scapula is all about. Now, in the Old Testament, there was a prophet called Elijah. And at one time, the people had gone away from God. So Elijah prayed for a drought so that people could suffer and come back to God. And then after some time, he prayed for rain. Now, Elijah used to stay on Mount Carmel. Now we're going to see why the scapula is called the scapula of the brown scapula of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. So when he was praying for rain, he would send his servant to look out to the sea. He sent him 7 times. On the 7th time, the servant said he saw something like a foot of a human. And this prefigured what we saw in the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verses 15, where God says he's going to create an embryo between a woman and the snake. They talked about what those two mean in a previous video. You can check it out. We know that the woman is Mother Mary and the snake or the serpent is the devil. So when the servant of Elijah saw the foot of the human, it prefigured the foot of Our Lady, Mother Mary, which was to crush the head of the snake or the devil. So at Pentecost, the followers of Elijah came down from Mount Carmel and joined the apostles, and then they became Christians. They started following Mother Mary. In fact, they built the first altar in honor of Our Lady at Mount Carmel. So it was one of the Carmelites later in the year around 1215 called Saint Simon of Stock who received the scapula from Our Lady. So Elijah used to have what they call, he had a garment. one side would hang in front and the other side would hang in the back. So it's called the mantle. This mantle used to work miracles. If you read the Bible, at one time he touched the water with it and the water stopped. And when he was going up to heaven, Elisha asked him for that mantle so that he could use his powers. So the scapular basically is a mantle of Our Lady. But over time, because of so many other reasons, it was reduced to these two pieces of cloth. But originally it was a mantle, one side would hang in front and another side would hang behind. So that's the biblical foundation of the scapular. Now the scapular was handed to Saint Simon of Stock, who was a Carmelite. He was a Carmelite, and in the year, let me cross check this, in the year 1251, on July 16th, 1251, that's when Our Lady handed the scapular to Saint Simon of Stock. So when she handed this scapular, there were promises attached to it. And I'm going to read for you the promises. Is the number one promise of the scapular, and I'm going to read this in the words of Our Lady. Whoever dies invested with this scapular shall be preserved from the eternal flames. It is a sign of salvation, a sure safeguard in danger, a pledge of peace, and of my special protection until the end of the ages. So, in short, Our Lady says, if you wear this scapular faithfully, you will never go to hell. That alone should make you get the scapular. If you are sure that this is a promise from Our Lady that if you die wearing this scapular, you will never go to hell, why wouldn't you wear? Why would you take that risk? Please get the scapular and do what I'm going to tell you, the other requirements. So that's the promise given to Our Lady for those who are the scapular. Now, I need to say this before we move on. Just because Our Lady said, if you die wearing the scapular, you'll never go to hell, does not mean that she has given you a license to sin. As with all sacramentals of the church, they only work when you are doing your best to be faithful to God, when you're doing your best to avoid mortal sin. Otherwise, they become what we call superstition. You cannot use these sacramentals and then you are indulging in sin and you think you're going to get the promises attached. So I hope that is very clear. The promise is also based on the fact that you must do your best to serve God. So the scapular does not have any prayer attached to it. It's wearing the scapular is a prayer. That is all you need to do. But this promise of saying you will never go to hell by Our Lady has conditions. You must be invested in this fraternity of the brown scapular. And how do you get invested? Any priest can invest you. Previously, there would be Carmelite fathers, but the church extended this because it spread out to the whole world. So any priest, as long as you're a Catholic, you can be invested in the brown scapular of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. An investiture is a process. There's a prayer which you can get online, which a priest is supposed to use. So you can search for it, you can Google it, and you get it. And then maybe if you need to be invested, and maybe a priest has not heard about it, or he doesn't know this prayer, you can give it to him. Now, there's another thing what they call the Sabbatine privilege. And the Sabbatine privilege reads like this, that Our Lady promised that whoever dies wearing the scapular and goes to purgatory, on the first Saturday, Our Lady will go to purgatory and remove that person and take the person to heaven. So before I move on, I'll first give the prerequisites. First of all, The scapula must be 100% wool. And these are the two pieces which I showed you at the beginning. 100% wool. If there any other material, that is not a scapula. Now I must warn you that there are many Catholics who buy what they call scapular rosaries, thinking that is a scapula. Those scapular rosaries are not made of wool. The rosary itself might be made of thread, but the pieces which make the scapula look like this, and this is plastic, this is not wool. So do not be deceived. If you're wearing a thread rosary, that is okay, but it does not qualify as a scapula. Then it must be, the shape must be either square or oblong. And when you wear it, one part must hang behind and another part must hang in front. You can wear it on your skin or on top of your clothing, that doesn't matter. Anything can do. Can you take it off? You're supposed to wear it for life, but maybe when you're going to shower, it is okay, you can take it off. That is fine. It must be brown. If you, there are so many other scapulars, but I'm talking about the brown scapula of a lady, so it must be brown. It shouldn't be a medal, because there are also scapular medals, and it has specific indulgences attached to it. So remember, this scapula is a garment of Our Lady. The way you see a child dressed in uniform, and you know this student is from this school, when the devil sees you wearing the scapula, automatically he knows that you're a child of Our Lady. So my dear brothers and sisters, I would encourage all of you to please wear the brown scapula of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Then the Sabbatine privilege, which I talked about, also has three conditions. Like I said before, the Sabbatine privilege is where Our Lady promised that if you die wearing the scapula on the first Saturday, if you have, in case you've gone to purgatory, on the first Saturday, Our Lady will come herself and take you. But to do that, you must, there are three requirements which you must fulfill. And number one, you must be invested by a priest. I talked about that. Number two, you must observe chastity in your state of life. Chastity means if you're single, you're not having any fornication or adultery. And if you're married, you're faithful to your wife. That is condition number two. Condition number three is you must pray what they call the little office of Our Lady. These are certain prayers, you can get them anywhere online. But alternatively, if you cannot do that, any priest who invests, you can change that to one rosary per day, or either the little rosary, the little office, or the rosary, or you abstain from meat every Wednesday and Friday. That is the third condition. Either you pray the little office every day, or the rosary every day, or you abstain from meat every Wednesday or Friday. You can choose any of those three. So those are the three conditions that you need to gain the Sabbatine privilege. Otherwise, thank you very much. And please, if you've not subscribed, please tap on the word subscribe, and then you will see it change to subscribe, so that I can get more followers and I can do more videos and add in more features. God bless.